Hi guys, it's Aaron from Solace. In this video, we're going to talk about how topics are implemented in Solace, how topic routing is achieved through subscriptions and wildcards, and we're going to look at some examples. So let's do it. So topics in Solace are not configured on the broker per se. Topics are defined by the publishing application at publish time. So think of it as a property of the message or metadata and not like you're writing to a file. So in my code, when I define a message, I'll have a payload, which can be JSON or XML or a binary blob or whatever you want. And when I send it, I send it with essentially a free text string that defines the topic that I create right there. So each and every message could be going to a unique topic if you wanted it to. Now you can use very simple topics if you want, but Solace supports a hierarchical data structure, a topic structure, that allows you to be very descriptive with the topic. So don't think of a topic as a destination or a label, such as transaction log or service request, but think of it more in the sense that the router, the broker, is doing all of the filtering and routing of these messages based on topics. So anything in your data or your payload of your message that you want to route or filter on belongs in your topic. So let's take a look at some real-world use cases as an example. So a foreign exchange trading platform. Maybe I want to have the location that the data is being published from as part of the topic string. I might even want to have the specific feed handler that's publishing that particular data. Maybe what type of quote it is. Maybe what kind of quality of service. Is it a real-time feed? Is it a delayed feed? Even the currency pairs that this quote is related to. You know, these could all be part of your topic string description. Next generation payments platform. I need to be able to do credits and debits, so that should be part of my topic string. Maybe the bank ID where this transaction is destined for. I could even have the card number as part of the topic string. And maybe the store ID where the point of sale terminal is located. These could all be part of the topic. And finally, how about an IoT application? Okay, so we have a connected buses platform. So buses are driving around, sending out periodic updates via GPS every couple seconds. So I might want to have the route number that the bus is on, the bus number specifically, even the latitude and longitude coordinates could be in the topic string. So these examples are just meant to give you an idea of the variety and how dynamic topics are in Solace, that each and every message could be actually going to a different topic. So with all of those topics and all that uniqueness, how do we manage that on the consumer side? Well, so on the consumer side, when an application connects to Solace and specifies a topic subscription, Solace, the broker, maintains that in essentially a giant list of all subscriptions for all clients. Think of it as a subscription matching engine. And so when a message is going to be published onto Solace, what essentially ends up happening is the topic is extracted out of the message, it's compared against this matching engine, and it generates a list of clients that are eligible to receive the message, and then Solace will forward the message onto the clients. Now this is done in a very dynamic real-time way. It's done on a message-by-message basis as they arrive at the broker. And so because of this, there's a strong order guarantee on topics in Solace. If two consumers are subscribed to the same topics, they will receive messages in the exact same order, always. Now, we just talked about how unique and dynamic and variable topics can be in Solace. So how do we manage that from a subscription perspective? Well, the answer is with wildcards. So with a single wildcard, I can match any number of published topics. Now, Solace supports two different wildcards. There's the multi-level wildcard, the greater than, which can match one or more levels used at the end of a subscription, or the star, the single-level wildcard, which will match anything up to the next level, to the next slash. And the star in Solace can actually be used as a prefix wildcard. So you can specify the first couple characters on that level. So going back to our use cases, let's take a look at some examples. So our FX trading platform, say all of the data is being published out of NY4 is tagged that way. With a multi-level wildcard, I could subscribe to all of the data coming out of that venue, regardless of feed handler or quote or whatever type of data it is. Maybe I just need to funnel that into some kind of regulatory database. Or I want to do a very unique type of subscription where I'm listening to all spot quotes in my real-time feed for euros against any currency across my whole global platform. So regardless of venue and regardless of feed handler. I could do that with the single level wildcard there. Our payments platform. Well, say I need to set up a new B2B channel for a new bank that's joined my platform. So if he's assigned ID number 18, it'd be very easy to subscribe a subscription for him and configure that as an async API connection so that all of the debit card transactions that are meant for him will get sent to him regardless of which store they're coming from. Or perhaps I've noticed some weird behavior coming out of a particular store, store 1049, and I want to listen to all credit card transactions for that particular store that start with the numbers 4817. Well, I could do that using the prefix wildcard as below. And finally, how about our IoT application, our buses that are driving around? Well, let's say I want to listen to all data coming out of route number 95. So all the buses, regardless of whether they're positional updates or status messages or trouble messages, communications, I can do that with a combination of the single level and the multi-level wildcard. Or more advanced thing, how about I want to listen to all positional updates for all buses in a particular area? Because I have the latitude and longitude encoded in the topic string, I can actually use the prefix wildcard. When I subscribe to 45.3 star, it will match anything from 45.30 all the way up to 45.399999, which essentially gives me a range. Similarly for the longitude. And if I want to illustrate that graphically, it would look something like this. It's not square because we're not at the equator. But this would essentially be the visualization of the subscription. And so every time a bus publishes a message with the completed topic string, it would, and if it was in that range, it would match this particular subscription. So that essentially means as buses drive through this area, if they're publishing their location as part of the topic string, I can actually filter and route that information to me like this. And as they move along and they tick, they send further updates every 5 seconds using MQTT, for example, this topic subscription would receive them until they ran out of the area. Okay, so I hope that helped explain how topics and topic routing are implemented in Solace, and maybe gives you some ideas on how to build a topic hierarchy for your particular use case. If you like this video, please give it a like. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more content from me and my colleagues. And be sure to check out our homepage at solace.dev for more developer tutorials, documentation, and stuff like that. So thanks a lot. See you later.